The Lord is truly risen. Alleluia. To him be glory and power for all the ages of eternity. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thank you.
Through your only begotten Son have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity. Grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's holy resurrection may through the renewal brought by your Spirit rise up in the light of life, and all of this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
The first reading is a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Cleanse my heart and my lips, O Lord, as you did those of the prophet Isaiah, that I may worthily and fittingly proclaim unto all your most holy gospel. The Lord is with you. A reading of the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark. And she saw that the stone was removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and she told them, "They've taken the Lord from the tomb. We do not know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but he did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. But they did not yet understand the scripture, that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of our Lord. I have long desired to give a talk about something which I think a lot of people take for granted. And a lot of people, a great many of the clergy. Because we celebrate liturgy, because we are intimately involved in the preparations, we think that everybody else has the same interest, the same point of view, the same understanding. And sometimes that is not the case. And I want to address something which I think is quite wonderful and quite beautiful on this Easter celebration, because it is an integral part of the celebration. The Paschal candle that we see here before us today is not just a decoration. It's not something we just put up for the Easter season and then we retire it to some other spot in the church to bring it out for baptisms and funerals. The Paschal candle serves a very specific purpose, and it is a purpose like that of an icon. Why do I say this? I say this because the Paschal candle is blessed at the Easter Vigil, and it really is its procession into the church, which is darkened, that splits the darkness and introduces a powerful theme. This theme is found in the Gospel of St. John. And you can tell that John was on the minds of many of the church fathers who gathered at the Council of Nicaea. For when they formed the creed, they inserted God from God, light from light, true God. The light of the Paschal candle remembers, brings about in our minds and in our hearts an awareness that God himself, in the person of his beloved Son, is very much with us. And that is why the candle is treated with great love and great respect, because it calls us to Jesus. cross is an integral part of the Paschal Canon. The wounds, which variously resemble the scourging and the crowning of thorns, and also the pounding of the nails to the hands and the feet, and the spearing of the side of Jesus, all of that is recalled in this. We see the crown at the very top, the nails in the hands, this wound in the side, and the feet bound together with one of the spikes, the nails that were put into the flesh of the Son of Man, Son of God. We also see a statement of theology and also a summary of the whole of the Bible in the Greek letters Alpha and Omega. Alpha being the first letter in the Greek alphabet, Omega being the last. And it is also indicative of Genesis, where the whole story for us begins, and Revelation, where everything is brought together in one complete unity, a unity which you and I are very much part of, because we too shall be gathered together with our saving Lord. So this candle is essential to our celebration, because this reminds us in a very physical way that Christ is risen. Christ is with us. And whenever we see that light shining, we are reminded of the great mystery that in the beginning was the Word, and that Word was the light of God, and that light was given to us so that we do not walk in the error of sin and darkness, but we come through Him to the primordial, to that first light that shone for our sakes at the creation of the world. Interestingly enough, just as we are celebrating our resurrection, we are also celebrating the incarnation. The mysteries interchange and interweave throughout the church year. And they do so that we will always keep in mind the great truths of our faith, a faith which we are privileged to confess, a faith that the fathers at Nicaea formulated into what we call the Creed. And so as we celebrate our Alleluias today, let us now stand. And as we profess our faith, let us remember that this creed speaks to us of an ancient truth which Augustine called ever ancient, ever new. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father, through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascends into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sin, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now, our prayer of faith.
For the intention of today's Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the victims of the pandemic and for all of our loved ones who have died in this last year, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Monsignors Leon New and Bill Gallagher, Fathers James Cronin, OSB, Carlton Westfield, Dennis Ryder, and all priests who have returned to the Lord since last Easter, in holy and pious memory, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the priesthood that where scandal has caused much harm, the Lord God will be pleased to raise up good priests to renew and help rebuild His holy church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families during this time of isolation, that they turn this current situation into opportunities to reconnect, rebuild, and strengthen their relationships to one another and to their God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For nurses, paramedics, doctors, policemen, and fire personnel, for grocery workers, delivery men and women, and all who put others first during this time of stress and strain, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have lost employment during this pandemic, that creditors may be generous and they assume they may return to work, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we pass from Lent into the Holy Paschal season, we petition that faith may be strengthened, hope renewed and rewarded, and that God will be pleased to rain down the blessings of charity upon each and all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us conclude the prayer together by saying, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Alleluia.
Thank you.
constantly reborn and nourished, and all of this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us now give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But on this day, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover is sacrificed, he is the true Lamb who takes away the sins of the world. By dying, he destroys our death. By rising, he restores our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." In song, the mystery of faith. Blessed apostles, our patron saint. may we then to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Alleluia. Therefore, let us keep the feast with the unleavened bread of purity and truth. Alleluia. Alleluia. What passes our lips as food, O Lord, may we possess in purity of heart. And what is given to us in time shall be our healing for eternity.
Thank you.
us now conclude our prayer. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and faith, so that renewed by the paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the holy resurrection. And all of this through Christ, our Lord. Have a glorious day. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son, the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia.